So, at the first sign of frostbite, I would suggest that you all get up, move around, and have a good old dance. So don't feel you've just got to sit there. We played here a few years ago, so it's got great memories for us. We played here with Arthur Lee and Love, and we had a great night. And we're going to have a great night tonight, too. The Zombies have been playing for over 50 years! And we're going to take you on some of the musical journey over those 50 years, backwards and forwards, from the early 60s right up until the present day. And this next song is from about 1965. It's a song written by the original bass player in the Zombies called Chris White. And this song is called I Love You. And for us, it was a B-side. The Zombies rather foolishly chose this as a B-side. But there was a Canadian band who saw something in this song, and they used it as an A-side. The band was called People. And this Zombies song went to number 3 in Billboard by somebody else. It's embarrassing. But there's a twist in the end of it. Okay, they got a number 3 hit record. Okay, we don't really care because we've got a national milk commercial on television at the moment using this song. So you see, the cream will come to the top. It's called I Love You.
I love you, but the words Well, thank you very much. You know, Colin and I got back together really by accident around the turn of the century. Which century, you may ask? It was actually the one that's just a few years ago, maybe 18 years ago, started. We only ever intended to play 6 gigs. And suddenly, somehow, that morphed into 18 years of travelling around the world. It's been quite extraordinary. And during that time, we decided after about 4 years, well, why don't we, you know, start to cut a couple of tracks again? And we did so. And we've had several albums out, but what we're going to do is a song from the first album that we did from once we were sort of reincarnated, if you like. It's a song called Sanctuary, but we're going to do it in a stripped-down version. You know, not like it was on the first album, but one that we did much later on a live album. And we thought we'd resurrect that and do it with bongos and acoustic guitar. And I hope you enjoy this. This one's called Sanctuary. Oh, your true devotion. Well, we really like to have fun with things like that, and you know, I hope you did as well. We're going to do two songs now from an album we made in 2015, and I just have to tell you, when this came out, we were on tour, and we were so knocked out because the album had just been released, and we got a phone call from Billboard magazine while we were on tour, and they said, "We just wanted you to know that for the first time in 50 years as the Zombies, you've got an album in the top 100 album sales charts." And the album is called Still Got That Hunger. We're going to do just three. Thank you very much. We're going to do just three songs from it for you tonight. Two now and one a bit later on. And these two are, the first one is a song which Little Stephen chose as the coolest song of the year last year on his radio show. And it's called Moving On. And then we're going to do Edge of the Rainbow. So here we go.
Moving on. I'm moving on.
seems like nothing is able to lighten the load from the edge of the rainbow. You see the light coming through. Sometimes when you're feeling just hard and pale, let us see there's nothing outside. Yeah.
Give me the
that hunger.
Last one we're going to do from the new album tonight, but we're now going to go to an album we made in 1967, an album called Odyssey and Oracle. And this album has a very strange story to it, because even though we had on it the biggest worldwide hit we'd ever had, a song called Time of the Season, number one in almost every country in the world, in spite of that, the album just at the time just crept into the 100, didn't really sell. And then, about 12 years later, it gradually started to pick up speed and to sell. And people like Paul Weller, who was at the time in the UK, he had the number 1, 2, and 3 hit singles on the crest of the sort of punk explosion. And he amazed us by saying that his favorite album of all time was Odyssey and Oracle. And that's something that he says to this day as well. He said that this year also. And thank you. Yeah. And from that point onwards, the main figures in rock and roll, from the late dear departed guy who became a friend of ours, Tom Petty, to people like Dave Grohl, to rock and roll royalty, but also many young hip developing indie bands, and again to the present day, they keep quoting this as being a favorite album of theirs. So this is something we never looked for when we did it 50 years ago, and it's fantastic. It sells more every year now than it did when it first came out. It's made the top 100 albums, top 100 albums in Rolling Stone chart of all time over the last few years. It's been in the top 30 albums of all time in the NME and various other papers in the UK. So we would love to do a set of four songs. Now, from obviously now. And we're going to start with a song that Dave Grohl, in a Scandinavian TV interview, said was the song which changed his life. It's a song called Care of Cell 44.
Morning to you, I hope you're feeling better, baby. Thinking of me while you are far away. Counting the days until they set you free again. Writing this letter, hoping you're okay.
Thank you. Here's the song they let me sing on the album. This one is called I Want Her, She Wants Me. No.
season, when love runs high in the stars, give it to me easy. Let me try.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much. We're going to do a song now which most people think I wrote, but I didn't. It was 90% of it anyway. It was written by Chris White, the original bass player with the Zombies. And it's Argent's biggest hit called Hold Your Head Up. Now, I can see some familiar faces in the audience here, and I know some people have heard this story a million times, but for those of you who haven't, it's great, actually, when everyone sings along with us, which they always do. Over the years, they've always raised the roof, and it's fantastic, and it's so joyful. But they always sing the wrong words. They sing, hold your head up, whoa, and that's not right. Believe it or not, the real words are, hold your head up, woman. So if you're going to sing this tonight, I really hope you do. For God's sake, get it right.
Thank you.
Tom Toomey on the guitar. Steve Broadford on the drums. Saren Koch on the bass. And we'd like to do for our last song, the first record we ever made, just about the first song I ever wrote. This one's called She's Not There.
I'm not afraid to die.
Well, thank you so much. You've been a wonderful audience this evening. It's been great fun for us. And we would just like to dedicate tonight's performance to the late, great Jim Rodman, who was the cornerstone of this band for over 20 years, and has sadly missed. And before he joined this band, he was a member of Argent. And we'd like to finish, as a sort of a dedication to him, we'd like to finish with one of Argent's great rock anthems. Many times this has been covered, but it's never been bettered. Argent's "God Gave Rock and Roll to You!"
Gave rock and roll to you. Gave rock.